most relatively good in terms of technical know-how, highly skilled workers, good equipment and instrumentation, and a very good financial backup to sustain high stock density. Keeping and growing Tilapia, while the market size entails a lot of responsibilities, this means an expenditure not only money but also time. Through continuous innovation and research, many problems are solved in intensive culture system, but greatly affected financially those privately funded commercial developments. Serious efforts towards practical and efficient plant design and understanding harnessing the available natural resources reduce the production costs. Native to Africa and Middle East, captured and free since biblical times. In Israel, they are called St. Peter's fish. The ancient Egyptians bred and raised them as source of food. The capacity of tilapia to adapt to a wide range of environmental situations surpasses the practical role under this species. It is precisely this capability that has resulted in their being used as an important food source in many tropical countries, where they are now farmed like carpet trout in Europe and North America. Tilapia, the second most common farm-raised fish in the world. The development of quality food stock is one of the key in the success of intensive tilapia farming. Three-way crossing of different species of tilapia is usually done. The species that are most commonly reared in aquaculture are in genus Oreprobis. These include the Nile tilapia, Oreochromis niloticus, the Mozambique tilapia, Oreochromis mozambicus, the Blue tilapia, Oreochromis oleus, and Oreochromis hornorum. The main objective of woodstock development is to tailor feed to the condition of the existing water of the farm, temperature, environmental and nutritional requirements to achieve the maximum growth rate from fry to status size the shortest time possible. Record keeping of the land-weight relationship, growth rate potential to age is a must to every farm. By religiously monitoring and recording this important data, will be your barometer in the eggs production during spawning. The industrialized tilapia farmer, breeders should produce uniform offsprings, meaning like growing only one or two tilapia which numbers in millions. Male and female tilapia are meticulously inspected by the highly trained technician. The female tilapia are separated from the male and put into conditioning tank, the smothering gonadal attrition. Being able to do synchronous spawning, production of eggs is maximized. Broodstock are always maintained on high-protein diet to maintain production of quality eggs that result into healthy fry. Male tilapia begins courtship display in front of the female. Only the male takes an initiative in courtship while the female plays merely a passive role. Female tilapia are expanded to courting. Male banded monogamous pairs remain together until the fertilized eggs is picked up by the female, and male tilapia will immediately look for another female and will readily meet again. Almost all tilapia are mouth brooders, where one of the parents takes up the eggs into its mouth for hatching. Cannibalism between fingerlings and fry are high among tilapia. The fingerlings will eat anything alive that is near eating fry. The female tilapia looks after the fry until they are able to swim around independently. The female tilapia will open her mouth as a refuge whenever any danger threatens the young. The spawning fan sex ratio is 1:3. Tilapia eggs are collected from the mouth of the female tilapia for artificial incubation. Bear in mind, the production of eggs in intensive tilapia farming is stronger than grow out of tilapia. The accurate record of spawning are very important in investigating the environmental or behavioral requirements needed for successful production of eggs may depend on being able to replicate these special circumstances that trigger spawning are multifactorial, consisting perhaps of combination of factors such as water temperature, presence of natural food for the survival of the fry, photo period and change in water chemistry. The female tilapia where eggs are collected are transferred to conditioning tank in preparation for another spawn. Reproductive success or hatchability must be done within age classes or on fish of similar sizes. Breeders should produce 80 to 100% male offspring, and sex reversal should not be more than 20%. Tilapia hatchery. Tilapia eggs are immediately processed by highly trained technicians for artificial incubation. Environmental changes play a direct part in the levels of stress level, and the acclimatization to hatchery water conditions should be done gradually. Scales and fingerlings are carefully separated from the eggs and fry. Continuous supply of clean water with a constant temperature between 26 and 28 degrees centigrade is maintained within the hatchery. Carefully separated from the eggs before pouring the eggs in the incubator jar. Yeah. original method of incubating tilapia eggs is a modified McDonald's jar. The jar is a tube within a tube designed to allow circulating water to enter the bottom of the jar to keep the eggs in circular motion without carrying eggs out of the jar. Newly had swim of fry are carried out of the jar by the upwelling water currents. Unhatched and hatched eggshells are immediately removed to prevent any contamination of water, which will be the cause of disease. This to ensure the survivability of the newly hatched fry. Once the fry start feeding, they are fed with high-protein diet every 2 hours. Any uneaten food and waste are immediately removed from the tank. Fry are moved to 30-footer circular tank where natural food is also available. They are still maintained on high-protein diet. Water suitable for growing fish or tilapia is a complex soup consisting of gases, minerals, solids, and many different organisms. The combination of proportions of these components and the resulting levels of, for example, acidity, alkalinity, hardness, salinity, and nitrogen for the type of fish you want to grow are vital for the long-term health of your tank. So managing the water chemistry of your tank involves first designing your tank from the outset with the correct basic materials, and then what source of water you're going to use. The amount of water and its availability. And then monitoring water quality regularly so that you can spot the correct problems very early on. In this way, fish and other inhabitants will not be subjected to any significant stress. It's true to say that the health of any fish is closely related to the health of its environment. The big concrete circular tanks, the water systems, and natural foods are food tube. Once the fingerlings reach the 10 grams weight and length of 1 inch, they are weighed and sampled in preparation for transport to grow out tank. Same age and sizes should be observed the date when it was transferred. In what tank should be recorded, and every 2 weeks the growth rate should be monitored. Acclimatization to water condition and tank environment should be done gradually. This is an SOP in every transfer of fish. Fish, like all animals, require a well-balanced diet, including protein, carbohydrate, fat, vitamins, and minerals. In intensive tilapia farming, fish, especially the high protein needed for growth, comprise the starter size, comprises 30 to 60% of the total operating costs of intensive tilapia farming. They efficiently grow a natural food that contains the much needed protein for growth. We greatly reduce the expenses for manufactured fish meals, especially the expensive high protein feeds. Dissolved oxygen, pH, ammonia, and nitrite is checked daily, including the water temperature of the tank on different places. Feeding of supplemental protein diet is maintained every day to assure their target weight of marketable size is achieved. Supply of water coming from your thermal deep well is maintained. These are some of the environmental requirements needed by tilapia to stay healthy. Hard alkaline water, 250 milligrams per liter calcium carbonate. Constant temperature of 26 degrees centigrade with a pH range of 8.6 to 9.2. Remember that the go-out aquaculture has no legal ecosystem balance. Rural plant controlled environment focusing the salt oxygen, waste management and levels, ability of water to ionization. Stocker-sized tilapia are harvested and transferred to high stocking density circular tank. Stocker size are transferred to the grow-out tank for marketable size tilapia. 100-footer concrete seafloor tank with high stocking density. A 5-horsepower paddy wheel is kept running 24/7. Demand feeders are used for feeding tilapia. It delivers the fish through continuous trickles of a small amount of feeds due to the pendulum-like movement created by the water current. Circular tanks used in intensive tilapia farming are self-cleaning. Passing of the accumulated waste in the center of the tank should be done regularly to maintain the healthiness of the water suitable for growing tilapia. Only the locally grown tilapia can supply the live market and can supply the needed demand of the market today. After all the money and time is spent in growing tilapia to market size, a very efficient winding and harvesting system. That minimizes stress and will not damage the scales and mucus of tilapia should be taken in serious consideration. By every tilapia farm selling their produce live to the end consumers. Level circular tank containing marketable size tilapia is still prepared for harvesting. Exceeded the farm expectation and proved to be significantly less traumatic to tilapia harvested for market. By minimizing stress and damage to scales and mucus, you produce a high quality tilapia uniform in size and a consistent product that can demand a competitive price. Tilapia remain calmly in the water while the smaller fish swim through the smooth surface of the drinking bars, and the marketable size as tidal waves do not scrape the scales or the mucus. The harvesting grading process needn't be unduly stressful or physically traumatizing to the workers or tilapia. By taking control of the making process, you deliver more fish because you can sort more tilapia with less time and labor. Do in few hours what took all day to do before. Holding camp for tilapia ready for market. Water temperature is lower and favorable to fish. Transporting your produce to outlet can be extremely stressful. Water temperature, dissolved oxygen, and ionized ammonia, and other ways that may contaminate and affect the quality of water inside your transport tank should be always monitored along the way. Delivery of light tilapia to outlet is twice a week. You must have a very good transport system in your delivery. The storage system of live market in the United States is an aquarium, and the outlet only orders the amount needed to be consumed in 3 to 4 days. The total health, some appearance and survivability of tilapia inside the aquarium of the outlet where they display your produce indicates its desirability to the end consumers. The United States market has the most demanding consumer. They want quality produce, tastier and safer fish to eat. The price they're willing to pay to ensure what they're eating is beneficial to their health and well-being.